Hi, and welcome to this video on See the Light, Easy Wins to Improve Your Asset Framework Experience. In the previous video, we went through the solution to the first problem we found, which was that when selecting through multiple form fill and seal machines, FFS 05 was not available. Having fixed that, we can now navigate to the form fill and seal display, and FFS 05 is now available. The next issue that was pointed out by the engineer is that on this, the overview display, there was an issue with the sugar FFS units. You can't really see it at the 8-hour time scale. However, if we switch down to 1 hour, it is possible to see that FFS 3, 4, and 6 all have the exact same trend. They've got the same average value, the same minimum, maximum, and standard deviation. So what this tells us is that there's a problem in that units 3, 4, and 6 are all referencing the same tag, the same PI tag, feeding that data. And we need to find out why that is and try and apply some best practices to resolve that issue. Now, the reason we are particularly concerned about the sugar units is that quality standards mean that we need to monitor the grain size of the sugar, and it has to stay within bounds. So one thing that you could consider doing, if this is your environment, is monitoring the sugar grain size, and if it goes above certain limits, either trigger a notification or log an event and just collect that data so that you know when you are in and out of bounds. To see how these tags are configured, again, we can't really see all of that information in PowerVision. We're going to have to switch across to Power System Explorer. And we've already got FFS03, which is one of the problem children. Sugar grain size is up here. We can see it's in the none category. The configuration it's using is a PowerPoint, which is FFS03.sugargrainsize. That looks fine. If we switch across to 4, okay, this now we can see that there's a problem because FFS unit 4 is also using FFS03.sugargrainsize as its PI tag. And lucky guess, assume number 6 is doing the same thing. Yeah, it is. Now, another problem that we can see here is that if going back to our previous example with form fill and seal machine number 5, the main issue there was that the device wasn't based off of a template. Having a look at the column on the left-hand side where all those green T's are, we can see that the sugar grain size for units 3, 4, and 6 are not based off of a template. Now, this was probably done in an effort to make sure that all of the salt packaging machines didn't have an empty attribute called sugar grain size. And traditionally, what you'll find is when you build a PI system asset off of a template, you are unable to edit the specific elements. So normally, you won't be allowed to add an individual attribute to an asset. However, what the IT department on our side found out is that in the library, when you are looking at the element templates, in our case, we're looking at the sandbox FFS, there is a tick box that says allow extensions. Now, allow extensions is very useful when you're in the testing phase, but for production, what it means is that you run into errors like we're having now, where copy and paste becomes a problem. And that's what I assume the issue is here, because we allowed extensions on the template, added the sugar grain size attribute to FFS03, and then copied and pasted it onto 4 and 6. Now, the problem with that is that someone forgot to go and change FFS03, the tag name, on units 4 and 6. That is something that is very easy to do. So what we want to do is disallow extensions. We don't want extensions to be used throughout the plant because it leads to a maintenance issue in future. The way we get around that is it is possible to use derived templates in PyAF. In our asset framework, in our library, the same way we create a hierarchy of elements, we can create a hierarchy of templates. And what we've done is we have created a template for sandbox underscore sugar underscore FFS. The only attribute this template has, if we have a look at our attribute templates, is the sugar grain size attribute. Now, you wouldn't be wrong for thinking that if I had to go ahead and create an element based off of the sandbox sugar FFS template, it would only have one attribute, because there's only one attribute template in the layout here. However, if you group by template, if you show all of the attributes by template, what this will do is it'll show you all of the attributes for the base templates as well. So in our case, sandbox sugar FFS has a base template of sandbox underscore FFS. So when we create an element off of sandbox sugar FFS, we're going to have all the attributes from the sugar FFS template as well as the base FFS template. In order to apply this fix, what we're going to do is we're going to go to our elements. And to apply the sugar template, we're going to right click on FFS03. We're going to convert it, and we're going to change the template. At the moment, it's based on sandbox FFS. We want it to be based on sandbox underscore sugar FFS. When we hit OK, you'll see that the sugar grain size is moved out of the category for none, and it is put into the process data category. Doing that for units 4 and 6, gets us about halfway there. Because the attribute name is the same, the Pi system doesn't want to automatically go and just overwrite all of your configuration. So sugar grain size will still be referencing the Pi tag FFS03.sugargrainsize. What we need to do in order to reset it to template is the same as we did with FFS05. I could select everything, right click, reset to template. I could just do that over here on FFS06, so I can right click on the attribute, say reset to template, and you'll see it applies the correct settings in our settings field. However, if you are doing multiple assets, doing this one by one can take a bit of time. So another way to do this is we'll check in our changes. And then we can do a search for our attributes. So if I go search, do an attribute search, I want every attribute that starts with the name sugar, because we're working with sugar grain size, and I'm not working in production. I'm working in the sandbox environment, and I'll go ahead and say search. And what you can see here is that all of our sugar grain size attributes are here. Go ahead, say OK. It adds it to the search, and I can reset them to template by right clicking and saying reset to template. Okay. Going back to our elements now, we can see that the sugar grain size is currently based on the template. It's got the green T. And to confirm everything's work, I'll go ahead, check in my change, open up PyVision, and let me just refresh the display. You'll see the change has taken place for FFS06 because we did that beforehand. On the next update cycle, when the web crawler checks for changes, we should see a change between FFS03 and FFS04. Great. Now you can see FFS03, FFS04, FFS05, and FFS06 are all based on the correct PI tag. And we have moved away from the extensions. Our last step is to go into our PI System Explorer, go to our library, and under General for Sandbox FFS, we want to take the tick off Allow Extensions. I'll go ahead check in. We can consider this one solved. And in our next video, we are going to go about solving solution number three, problem number three, and that is where we had the issue with the sealer temperatures.